Joe, do you have the topic bucket ready?
I do.
All right. These are topics that we were unable to get to, but going to spend a little time with each one of them now. Have you ever done a topic bucket?
I have done the topic bucket before. I'm excited to do it once again.
Erik Woodworth, Die Laughing Productions, in for Justin today. Joe, topic bucket.
All right, here we go. What color eggs do you buy and why?
White.
White, generally, yeah.
Racist. Brown ones freak me out. I don't know why.
They don't freak me out, but I just like, I
do
feel like I have
more?
To. I don't know. I don't believe so. There's no real price difference.
And why are some white and why are some brown?
I think those are the chocolate ones.
Are those the chocolate?
It takes chocolate chickens to make brown eggs.
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Are they the cage-free ones?
Not enough color has to do with cage-free.
I think there's somebody out there that knows. Oh, cool, like, yeah. That's screaming at the radio
no, they're
right
texting
now.
In as
like,
we speak.
You're just like that. It's not like that.
And if I see another meme about the price of eggs, just stop.
Yeah.
Stop with the memes.
I haven't had any problem finding eggs.
It's not finding them. It's the price of them.
Yeah. Then say like $2, they've gone up to like $6. And I'm like, it's okay. Well, they're still like the cheapest thing you could buy at the grocery
and
store.
I will say this, shout out Steve Rouse, radio legend. I love you. I miss you. I got to come out to the farm, Rouseville Farms. I've been over to his farm a bunch, and he's made me some. He had chickens. He since reduced the number of chickens he had, but he had a, you could live in this thing. It was so big. It was a chicken
big coop
that looked like a house, and he would have fresh chicken eggs, and he made me some fresh eggs.
I do love a fresh farm-to-table egg.
Oh, they taste incredible.
They taste like a little bit of processing that hasn't happened.
Exactly.
A little bit more of the world. Maybe it's just me.
Topic bucket!
All right. Who gets the middle gas option? Why does it even exist? Does anybody use the middle gas option?
It's so funny you say that. I was on the I don't think we were in Jersey, because Jersey, you can't pump gas, right? You can't pump your own gas. I was on a road trip with my buddy Lou. And we get out, and I get gas, and I hit 89. And he looks at me, and he goes, what are you, a psycho? He goes, who gets 89? And I went, you're right. It's you either go 87 or 93. Why would you ever go 89?
Yeah, that is kind of nuts. Who uses it? Is there a car that specifies that you use that? I mean, it's always you use the high test, or you just put the garbage gas in. That's what I always looked at it as.
I always go 93.
You go premium. You're a well-to-do personality.
My little car, my Honda S2000, I have to put premium in it. It only takes 93. And then I think from there, I'm just like, well, I'm putting it in all my cars.
You go across the board at that point.
Yeah.
See, I finally, my old lady got a new car. She got a Dodge Challenger.
Oh.
With the Hellcat thing. It's pretty cool.
Is it a Hellcat?
Yeah.
It is a Hellcat.
Yeah. It's purple. It's pretty good. But yeah, that's the first car that
93.
Yeah, prem it up every time. You gotta prem
Speaks,
it up.
What number you go with?
I go 87.
You do go 87.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's hilarious, Joe. Yeah, who gets 98? Topic bucket!
87's also a year that the max year he'll date.
Yeah. That's right.
All right. How many pillows do you sleep with?
One.
Oh, whoa.
Single. Yeah.
Wow, really?
I do two pillows.
All right.
One for your head?
Both for my head.
Two?
Yeah. I like to be propped up.
Why don't you just buy a bigger, fluffier pillow?
I don't know. I've never tried that. I like to be higher, I suppose.
I only need one, and I usually don't sleep with a pillow. So oftentimes, I sleep in a recliner. That's where I'm most comfortable, 100%.
Did you say most times?
Most times
sleep
I sleep
in a recliner.
I like to be
like
in a
last
reclined.
Night.
Yes.
You slept in a recliner?
I sleep in a recliner because that's where I need to sleep.
Why?
To be the most comfortable for me. Because otherwise, I have back issues. If I sleep on like a regular bed, I will wake up and it feels like my spinal cord has been twisted in a way that I need to like warm myself up. But if I sleep in a recliner, I'm generally okay. If to sleep on my back, I want it as firm as possible. And if I do have to sleep.
And now you're not sleeping. You don't sleep next to the lady.
No, we're both snorers. We're adults.
Lady.
We can be in different rooms, okay?
Okay.
That's it's easier that way. And I thought that was weird telling people, but a lot of people do it. Truly, they do.
Yeah, I think it's more common than people admit to. My bed's super depressing because it's just me. So it's like a giant king size bed with one pillow. And that's it. It's like I have all the decorative pillows. They sit in the corner.
Yeah.
They never make it on the bed. It's just whatever.
Who needs it?
What do you do, Joe?
I'll start with three or four.
What?
Yeah, like
where are they?
Basically like sitting up almost.
So they're all underneath your head?
Yeah. Head and upper back.
And back.
Kind of propped up a little bit as I'm falling asleep. But then I'll usually end up with like two.
Okay.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Give me a couple more. Topic bucket.
All right. What do you approximate your overall screen time per day? How long are you looking at a computer, cell phone, video games, all combined?
Oh.
Most of my day.
And TV?
Yeah. Any screen.
A lot.
Yeah, I know. It's bad.
All day.
Yeah.
All day.
When I'm driving, that's the time I'm not. And as soon as I get home, I'm surrounded by screens. And when I work out, so if I were to take it in between sleep, my workout, and driving, and the time I actually have to force myself to read a book, it's been my New Year's resolution.
Me too. I've been reading.
I read my book
every
day. Well, I finished The Shining. I started out the year reading The Shining.
Oh, that's a good movie. I love that movie.
How's the book? I mean, they always say the book is better than the movie.
It's so much different than the Stanley Kubrick classic, the
Stephen
King one.
Overlook Hotel, right?
Yeah.
That's right.
And now I'm reading The Talisman currently.
Oh,
of course.
So I don't know what that is.
Talisman.
It's another Stephen King property that the Duffer Brothers of Stranger Things are going to be making soon. So I'm trying to get ahead of it.
I am currently reading All Quiet on the Western Front.
Oh, did you see All Quiet on Western Front?
I saw it. So I wanted to read it.
2018 one or whatever?
I'll tell you what, though. When you read the book, they can just go into so much detail.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, my God. The way they describe these young, innocent kids who thought they were, like, going off. Because you got to realize, we now know what war is like. Because we have seen the pictures. We have seen the videos. We have read the books. Back then, they didn't know. They're like, we're going to war.
Woohoo! It's going to be awesome.
And they're all excited. And then they describe like them getting out there and being like, holy.
Well, it's also World War I is crazy because war was like that before. You put on like pretty clothes and you went out.
Yeah.
Some people died, but not everybody. There'd be lots of prisoners. But World War I, you're like, oh, no, you just get gunned down and there's casualties after casualties. It's nuts.
One more topic bucket.
All right. Real quick. Do you wash your dishes immediately or do you wait till the sink is full?
Immediate. I'm an immediate guy, usually.
I'm like a 50-50, I'll be honest. Sometimes I leave them sitting in there for a bit.
Yeah.
I do this thing. Sometimes I will leave them out. If I don't immediately do it, they'll be on like a table somewhere near the sink. But
so you
I never
keep the sink free, but they're
the
not
sink
washed.
Free, but
got it.
Yeah. If I take some down in the basement and I'm eating power, I'm like sometimes I'll let it sit a couple days and then I'll take it back up.
What about you, Josh?
What was the question?
Do you wash your dishes immediately or let them sit in the sink?
I don't have dishes. I have paper plates.
That's why you're the news genius.
Actually, I have some dishes. I just don't use them.
But look, you're a genius because you don't have to do dishes. I also have paper. I do use paper a bunch. It's very easy.